I believe if you stumbled upon this video, then you're not very clear with how AdaBoost works. This is my take on simplifying this complex algorithm. I hope you all like it. If you do like the content on my channel and if you happen to like this video as well, please consider clicking the subscribe button, as that will motivate me to make more such funky videos and explain more concepts in the most simplest possible manner. Most of the research papers kind of give you this simple pseudocode as to how to understand AdaBoost, but my idea is to give you a more simplified version of AdaBoost. So let's start with that. One simple assumption that I have before I start explaining how AdaBoost works is that you know a bit of intuition behind what boosting is. If you are still not very clear on how boosting works, then I've created a video on boosting. I'll share that across in the links. You can go through that video and come back to watch this video again. As we all know, AdaBoost or boosting in general is a sequential process wherein we create multiple weak classifiers into a big ensemble strong classifier. The first step of AdaBoost is to initialize weights to all training points. At initialization, every point that I'm using for training a AdaBoost classifier will be assigned a weight equal to the reciprocal of the total number of points that are present in my training data set. For example, if I start with 10,000 samples, then each point at the initial training phase will be given a weight of 1 by 10,000. The next thing that AdaBoost will do is, it will calculate the error rate for all the weak classifiers that are present. What I mean by that is, it will grow multiple decision stumps or small decision trees, calculate how much of an error is achieved by every decision tree, and then the next step would be to pick the classifier or to pick the decision stump which gives the lowest error rate. Once you've formulated or once you've narrowed down on the best classifier, the next thing is finding out the voting power of that classifier, which is given by the formula half log to the base e, 1 minus the error that you've achieved from the previous best classifier divided by that error again. This basically gives the classifier, the weak classifier, a strength in terms of how much is it more accurate as compared to the other weak classifiers. Once I've computed the voting power for the weak classifier, I append that classifier into my ensemble classifier of f of x, and then I ask myself a question: is f of x good enough for making a strong prediction, or have I gone around multiple rounds to create a very strong classifier, or are there no good classifiers left that I can create? One way to smartly judge if you've completed enough rounds is to check if the best classifier has an error rate of 1 by 2. Once you've evaluated that, and if you feel there are multiple more rounds that you have to conduct in terms of creating more weak classifiers with some voting power, then the next step is you update the weight of every training point based on if it was classified correctly or if it was classified incorrectly by the previous classifier. If it was classified correctly, the weight of that training point goes down. And for the points which were classified incorrectly by my previous classifier, the weight of that point goes up by the formula that is given below. And you again repeat the process by calculating the error rate for every possible classifier, find out the best classifier, and you iterate over this loop till the time you feel that you've had enough rounds to create the best possible ensemble classifier or the best possible AdaBoost classifier. If this idea is clear, let's proceed to an actual example. In my previous slide, I showed you that there were 6 building blocks of AdaBoost. With this example, in whichever step I am, I will highlight that block as to where I'm present in this scheme of 6 blocks so that you have complete clarity as to what is going on in the algorithm. The example is going to be fairly simple. I've just taken 5 points with 2 features x1 and x2 corresponding to x-axis and y-axis. And I've drawn a scatter plot. I have points at 1, 1, 1, 5, 3, 3, 5, 1, and 5, 5. 4 points belong to class 1 and are denoted by the plus sign. 1 point, that is 3, 3 point, belongs to class 0 and is denoted by minus sign. Going by what we have learned, we'll first initialize all our training points, that is WA, WB, WC, WD, and WE by 1 by n, where n in our case is 5 because we have 5 training points. So all the points are equally weighed with a value of 1 by 5 or 0.2. Now that we've understood how weight initialization happens, Let's go to the next step, that is finding out the error rates of multiple classifiers. What I've done here is I have considered every decision tree vertically, which is also known as decision stump. A decision stump is nothing else but a decision tree with just one split. So I have various combinations of decision trees with me. One of them is x less than 2, the other is x less than 4, x less than 6, x greater than 2, x greater than 4, and x greater than 6. The way you read this is, for x less than 2, everything left of 2 is considered as class 1 or positive. Everything right of 2 is considered as negative or class 0. If I consider x less than 6, then all the points less than 6 are considered as class 1. All the points greater than 6 are considered as class 0. When I come to x greater than 6, then all the points greater than 6 are considered as class 1 or positive points. All the points less than 6 are considered as class 0. So what we'll be doing is we'll be iterating over every such decision tree combination, finding out the error by summing the total weights of the misclassified points, and then finding out the best classifier that exists in that particular round. Since this is round 1, we'll be having multiple rounds after this as well. So let's consider the case where we have a decision tree having a value of x less than 2. Any point less than 2 is considered as positive. Any point greater than 2 is considered as a negatively classified sample. So if you look closely, I have two samples, that is B and E, being misclassified. They were actually positive samples, but when I consider x less than 2 as my decision tree split, then these two points are incorrectly classified as negative, although they were positive in nature. So I have a column called as wrong, which denotes the misclassified samples that I have, which in this case turned out to be B and E. I add both the values of the weights of B and E. So if you look closely, WB has a weight of 1 by 5. WE has a weight of 1 by 5. If I add 1 by 5 with 1 by 5, I get a error rate or total error rate of 2 by 5. Let's look at the next decision tree combination, which is X less than 4. Any value less than 4 is positive. Any value greater than 4 is negative. The point at 3,3 is considered positive, but it is actually negative. Point B and E are actually positive, but because of the split that is made, both of them are considered or predicted to be negative. So I have three points which are misclassified now: B, C, and E. And if you sum all the weights together, then the value turns out to be 3 by 5. I go a step further. I say x less than 6 is my next decision tree. Any value less than 6 is considered to be predicted positive. Any value greater than 6 is considered to be predicted negative. So right now, all my samples would be predicted as positive. I'll have one misclassification, that is point C. And the error rate would be the weight of just C going wrong, which is 1 by 5. I do this exercise for x greater than 2. So any point greater than 2 would be considered positive. Now, because of this, points B, C, and E would be considered as positive. So there is a clear case of misclassification where A and D are misclassified as negative, although they are positive, and C is misclassified as positive, although it is negative. So if I add the total weights of all the three misclassified points, that is A, D, and C, I get an error rate of 3 by 5. I do this exercise for x greater than 4, wherein I get a value of error rate equal to 2 by 5. And I do this again for x greater than 6, wherein there are 4 points which are misclassified, A, B, D, and E. And I get an error rate of 4 by 5. Now let's pick the lowest error rate classifier. If I go through the error rates column, I find that x less than C, which just misclassifies one point, is having an error of 1 by 5. I will pick that point and I'll use it later on to compute the voting power of that point. So I am at step 3, where I'm now picking the lowest error rate classifier, which in our case turned out to be x less than 6 for the first round. Since we have already done this, let's go ahead and find out the voting capability using the formula half log to the base e 1 minus e by e, where e is the error rate of the best classifier from the previous step. So as you can recollect, the minimum error rate was 1 by 5, I calculate alpha, which is equal to half log of 4, where log is here to the base e, and I append that classifier with its voting capability into h of x. So h of x at this stage is half log to the base e 4 into f, which is my classifier or decision tree classifier, x less than 6. Now I ask myself a simple question. Is my h of x good enough? Have I had enough rounds? Or is my best classifier having an error rate of 1 by 2? Since none of these answers are giving me a true value, I'll go on and update the weights of every point in my training data set, where w new equal to w old divided by 2 into 1 minus e, where e is my error rate of my previous best classifier. And this holds true when the point is classified correctly. If the point is classified wrongly, then I increase the weight of that particular point by the formula w old divided by 2 times e, where e is the error of the best classifier from the previous step. As you can recollect, points A, B, D and E were correctly classified. So I'll sneak in the values of w old, which was equal to 1 by 5 from the previous examples, and the error rate of the best classifier, which turned out to be 1 by 5 in the first equation, since all of those points were correctly classified, and we get a value of 1 by 8 for the correctly classified samples. We do the same exercise for the wrongly classified sample, which in our case was point C. Plugging in the values in the second equation now, we get WC equal to 1 by 2. As you can clearly see, the point which was misclassified has a higher weight as compared to the points which were correctly classified by my previous classifier, thus giving in more importance to point C to be classified correctly in the next round. Now, I again iterate through the multiple decision trees that I have and find out the error rate with respect to the new weights that I have in place. So again, for x less than 2, b and e are wrong. I add their corresponding weights to get an error rate of 2 by 8. I do that for x less than 4, x less than 6, x greater than 2, x greater than 4, and x greater than 6. If you notice carefully, the green value has been modified owing to the weight that it corresponds to in this round. Now, I formulated the errors of various classifiers, keeping into account the weights of my points. Now, I'll be choosing the best classifier having the lowest error rate. As it is evident that I have two classifiers now, x less than 2 and x greater than 4, which have the minimum error rate, that is 2 by 8. Now, I will select the one that comes in first, which in our case is x less than 2. So once we've selected that the best classifier from this round is x less than 2, we again follow the normal process of finding out the voting power for that classifier. We first find out the error, or we first use the error that we've computed, which is 2 by 8. We calculate the voting power, which is alpha, which turns out to be half log to the base e 3, and we append this value of the classifier along with its voting power into our overall classifier structure. So h of x now becomes half ln 4 into f x less than 6, which was our first decision tree, plus half ln 3 into f of x less than 2, which is our second decision tree. Now again, I ask myself the same question again. Is h good enough? Have I had enough rounds? Or is there no good classifier present? None of the answers are true, so I proceed forward. Since I am proceeding forward, I have to again update the weights. Going by the formula again, w new equal to w old divided by 2 into 1 minus e, if the point is correctly classified, or if it's not correctly classified, then the formula changes to w old by 2 into e. Points B and E are incorrectly classified, so the weights of those points are heavily blown up as compared to points A, C and D. I go forward, I again repeat the process of finding out the best classifier. For this combination of weights, x less than 2, I get an error of 1 by 2, x less than 4, I get an error of 10 by 12, x less than 6, I get an error of 4 by 12, and so on and so forth. As always, I pick the lowest error rate classifier after performing that exercise. And in this case, it turned out to be x greater than 4, wherein my misclassified points were A and D, and it gives me an error of 2 by 12 or 1 by 6. Now I find out the voting power of my classifier. The voting power in this case turns out to be half ln of 5, and I append that classifier again to my overall stacked meta classifier, which is H of X. So I have a combination of 3 classifiers now. Now I ask myself the question again, have I had enough rounds? If you think carefully, I had 5 training data points. The first classifier was misclassifying point C. The second classifier was misclassifying points B and E. The third classifier was misclassifying points A and D. If I have a vote wherein a point is near to point A, my third classifier would maybe misclassify that point, but it would be overridden by the first two classifiers. That is how the voting power is given to the classifiers as well. For a given point which is being misclassified by one classifier, the combination of other two classifiers would override the vote of that particular classifier, which is going wrong. So for each of the training points, only one classifier is wrong about it and the other two are correct. So this is a good place to stop. So this was my idea of simplifying a complex algorithm like AdaBoost. If you do have any questions with what we've covered in this video, then feel free to ask in the comment section below and I'll do my best to answer those. If you enjoy these tutorials and would like to support them, then the easiest way is to simply like the video and give it a thumbs up. And also it's a huge help to share these videos across with anyone whom you think would find them useful. Please consider clicking the subscribe button to be notified for future videos. And thank you so much for watching.